I'm Eddie Grijalva. I was born in El Toro, California, February the 7th, 1933. The little town of El Toro, to me, was a beautiful place to be living then.
During the mid to late 1800s, Orange County pioneers James Irvine, Lewis Moulton, and Richard O'Neill began purchasing large sections of untamed land. From those earliest times, small towns like El Toro were born. El Toro was a melting pot of immigrants, each contributing to its eventual growth as a city. They were farm workers, teachers, blacksmiths, ranch hands, and everything in between. Eager to succeed as a community, they did whatever needed to be done. As Eddie tells his story, a picture of life in early El Toro begins to unfold.
There was not very many people, not very many cars. Your roads, your biggest road would be a two-lane road. The biggest one would be El Toro Road that go from, at that time, the 101, now it's the 5. The hills, a lot of the hills were planted with different type of beans, lima beans, black-eyed beans, navy beans. And then some of the farmers there had orange orchards, lemon orchards, and even there was walnut groves. The house that I was born and raised was not a modern house at all. It was all wood, and it wasn't even tongue and groove. It was just boards. We had no utilities in this house, nothing at all. No water, no running water, no electricity, no sewage. A bathroom, we had an outhouse. You know what an outhouse is? I was always barefooted, never wore shoes. The only time I wore shoes when we had to come to Santa Ana to Sunday school. I don't like to use the word poor. I wasn't poor. We had a lot of love in our home. We never had no need for food. Dad was a good provider. I remember the jobs he had was mostly working for the Moulton Ranch because his father was Guillermo, my grandfather, he was working for Luis Moulton. Sometimes when I guess things got slow at the ranch, some period of the time, he'd work for the other farmers around that had citrus, because he'd help them when it was going to freeze. He would help the farmers like the Bennetts and Mr. Fox and West farmers that had orchards. He'd go help them and he'd light smudge pots because it'd freeze. And I remember they'd come by the house and the day that evening before it was cold in the winter, and they'd stop by and tell me, "Hey, Louis, don't forget, it's going to freeze in the morning." The Moulton Ranch, it was something that I had never seen before, with all these buildings, different type of buildings, and way in the back. I guess that's the area where this mess hall was. I had no idea what a mess hall was. I remember seeing the Luis Moulton and the wife once, two, three times I'd say I saw her. But I saw her from afar, you know. But Luis, you know, he'd walk by, I guess he's taking his walks, I don't know. And he'd say hello and hello. That's the only people that I met were the Moulton family. When it was time for lunch that the Moulton Ranch provided for the ranch hands, my dad would yell out to the hands, says, "Lunchy! Lunchy! Lunch!" It was just mind-boggling. Me, a kid there, and then there's flop a big old steak in front of me, and all I know that in the middle of the big tables, there was all kinds of food and the milk. And then I thought we were through, and all of a sudden here comes this huge, huge pies. What a taste. It was out of this world. You know, as a kid, to me, that was died and gone to heaven. I asked my father one day, "Hey, Dad, where did my ancestors come from?" Because I used to hear the kids in school talking about, oh, their grandfather, great-great-grandfathers come from Germany and England and all over. And so I asked my father one day, where did my grandparents come from? And he just looked at me and he said, don't worry about that. So as I grew older, I went to the Bowers Museum, Santa Ana. So I went into this historical room and I'm looking at it, and lo and behold, one wall, it had all this information about the rancheros, the ranchers of 1700s. And I saw the name on the wall, El Rancho Santiago de Santa Ana by Don Juan Pablo Grijalva. I said, Grijalva? I said, my God, what's going on here? I was interested. My great-great-grandmother was full-blooded Native American. My father was half, I'm a quarter Native American and Spanish.
On December 7th, 1941, the news of war shook the tranquility out of small towns everywhere. Soon, El Toro found itself in the crosshairs of the fight.
All of a sudden, everybody was talking about the war. What's going on, Dad? The Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor. Changed our world, our life. And then, before I knew it, we got the news that they're going to build this an air base between El Toro and Irvine area. So that road that we used to take all of a sudden was closed off, because that area is where they built the El Toro Marine Base. And they named the base El Toro Marine Base, a kind of the little town of El Toro. Beans fields all over. That's all they planted in that area was beans. And the road we took would run right in the middle, what the Marine Base turned out to be. And that was a big event. I remember when they closed the streets and we'd see the progress of the base, and we'd take our bikes and ride up there, and all of a sudden you see like a city going up. So it was a big, big thing. I was there when they built it, and I was there when they closed it. Pretty good events that happened in my lifetime.